After the privatisation of NHS transport services in Sussex, some patients have reported that they have had to wait hours for an ambulance. Co-performer, the private firm that now runs the transport service, took over hospital transport on the 1st of April. But 8 days later, an investigation was launched when several patients' appointments were missed. A couple of weeks ago, another patient was the victim to the unreliable system. He died not long after his ambulance made him miss vital tests for his lungs.
He was extremely distressed about that. Now, the family are not suggesting it was necessarily the reason why he died so shortly afterwards. However, they do know that it reduced him to a very anxious, stressed gentleman in his last few days, because he'd been expecting a test that he thought was going to help him to recover or at least feel better, and that test never arrived. Shortly afterwards, he deteriorated so much he had to be taken in, not the same day but a few days later, by an emergency ambulance, and he never recovered. He deteriorated rapidly and died last weekend. And the family are just so upset that his last few days were made so anxious by that occurrence.
Co-performer apologised to patients still experiencing delays. However, the problems still remain.
The company that were running the service, which was called CCAM, and as far as I know were running it quite satisfactorily, said they just couldn't perform, do this targets that were being expected for the money that was put on the table for this service, whereas co-performer decided that they could. Now they can't, because they're not turning up left, right and centre. Apparently there is absolutely nobody else can step in and take over. The old company has been disbanded, so they're not there to pick up the pieces, and sadly that there's just people being left without their transport to very important hospital appointments, including such things as dialysis, cancer treatment. They're just not getting their service.
This is Holly Keogh for Latest TV News.